Let's take a quick look back at the moments where a journalist was at odds with a country's president. Here are the details.
Rappler CEO Maria Ressa's cyber libel case may be the first of its kind against a Philippine president. But legal battles involving journalists and the highest official of the land is nothing new in the country. One of the most celebrated cases lapped against the media was the 1987 libel suit filed by the late President Cory Aquino against Philippine star columnist Luis Beltran. The firebrand commentator claimed that Mrs. Aquino hid under her bed at the height of the 1987 coup attempt led by rebel soldiers under then-Colonel Gringo Honorio. Former Senator Rene Sagisag, Mrs. Aquino's spokesman at the time, says Cory felt insulted. Amid the security threats facing the government, like the protracted communist insurgency and the rising military adventurism, Mrs. Aquino believed Beltran's under-the-bed tirade projected her as a weak and coward leader, which could only embolden her enemies.
It's a personal decision eh. Dahil hindi ko alam kung yung mga taga-Malacanang noon would have advised her dahil pag tinawag mo siyang kurakot, etc., that would have been damaging.
Beltran apologized to Mrs. Aquino, but the former president still pursued the case. She even sat on the witness stand during the trial.
I believe, just as you, that we have to uphold the freedom of the press, but I hold also that along with the freedom comes a very serious responsibility and obligation, sir.
In 1992, the Manila RTC sentenced Beltran and Philippine Star publisher Max Oliven to 2 years in prison and were ordered to pay 2 million pesos in damages. The Court of Appeals, however, dismissed the case in 1995, acquitting Beltran and Oliven. But it was too late for Beltran, who died a year after the case was dismissed. Up to this day, Beltran's son Sito, who is also a columnist and broadcaster, cannot fully grasp how a statement, which was a mere figure of speech, was used to sue his father.
How that judge, that RTC judge, even found my father guilty when the president herself pointed out that she couldn't possibly fit under the bed because there was no space under the bed. Diba? Logic lang would say, apparently, you know, she was, like I said, misled into believing that my father was calling her a coward, which is, you know, really tragic. Going to court, filing cases, it was more for just to make a point. Parang just to show you that I am not guilty, that you are wrong, etc. So politicians go to court. But for the longest time, no libel case ever prospered.
Last week, social media went abuzz after some supporters of the administration posted a video clip of the court proceedings against Beltran. A number of them criticized Ressa in light of the Beltran libel case, saying the late columnist did not resort to dramatics when he was charged and arrested by authorities, unlike the Rappler CEO, who allegedly played the victim card against the Duterte administration, even if the cyber libel suit came from businessman Wilfredo King. The case stemmed from Rappler's 2012 article, which implicated King to human trafficking and drug smuggling. Ressa said that her arrest was an abuse of power and weaponization of the law to curtail press freedom. But for Sito, his father and Ressa's case are far different.
No, this is not about press freedom. The case of Luis Beltran was, you know, clearly misled and misinformed president. Dito kay Ressa at kay Duterte, politika ito eh. Press freedom is when we are denied to write, when we are denied access to information, etc. But if you're sued for libel by a private citizen, then it's kind of hard to make the association.
Sagisag, for his part, believes that Ressa may not have been driven to a corner had she looked the other way. But the Rappler CEO is just determined to trade blows with the president.
Kung Maria Ressa and Rappler had been praising Digong all this time, wala itong kasong to. So ang crime niya being a critic of the president, purely personal.
Aside from cyber libel charges, Ressa is also facing 5 tax evasion cases. But only time will tell whether these cases will spell conviction against perhaps the president's staunchest media critic. For News 5, Jen Calimon, We Are One News.